All right, so this morning I'm going to talk about the edge of discovery of a truth, and what is believed in truth, and what is, as time progresses, you heard the gossip down the road, and then you get an update. And then you may find yourself in like, oh my gosh, you know, maybe I stood on that previous information. I stood heartily, and so now I find myself a rug pulled out from underneath. You know, maybe I said something. I stood up for that particular bit of gossip, that bit of data, that bit of information. And now my reputation is on the line. I have new, fresh update. So now what? Because I've now been, this is the person who's been out there blabbing about the town, saying, she didn't do this, or she didn't do that. So, when all of this is going on, and all of a sudden you find out new, that you were erroneous. Okay, so you have the person who's now erroneous, who's been spreading the data also. Yeah. So then they have that protection. They want to protect their persona. They want to protect what they've said. They want to make sure that, hey, they can still have a clean slate in the eyes of others, you know. They want to protect that they have a reputation still. They don't want their reputation ruined by the gossip that they've spread erroneously. So, yeah, it's a drama, isn't it? So you have that little bit, meanwhile, somebody, you know, has a gun to their head, you know, because they're a day trader. Meanwhile, yeah, stories of allure deep into the mix here. I've got, hostage held situation. And no, they didn't pay. Anyway, it's all right, you know. It was okay to be there by myself all those years. Sorry you got it wrong, blabbing about, hey, I've got a famous opera singer. Sorry you got it wrong. Nobody knew me as that. They only knew me as the ballet dancer. So my hostage takers got it wrong. So I returned here now. And now we're living in erroneous. And it's interesting how a person will just there's a certain little bit of data you can say. You can say, oh, she was evicted. She didn't pay her rent. And that's it. That would be like, that's a judgment done with no other data necessary in a person's brain. And I'm like, that is incredible to me that you have that small, short-sighted pinpoint of an arrow in somebody's head, that that's all they require. When they were never there, when they never signed the contract, when they never knew if I signed the contract. It's very simply a misunderstanding, but yet that person is back to their small little mind living in erroneous. And so now they have to protect their, well, I'll call it their reputation. Their word is, their word is erroneous gossip. So how do they fix it now? Anyway, yeah, how do they fix it now? And meanwhile, does my husband have a gun to his head? It's my fault. I put him into the day trading. I pushed him to do it. I was the greedy one. I was the greedy one in thinking that he would be very good at it as a successful career. I was the bad wife who found it there as a foundling. Yeah, he's good at it. So it's my fault. It's my fault. You understand? And then, for certain, you know, put him in the most gluttonous enterprise out here. It's called the internet, and put him out there on this stupidabout.com. Put him out there, and so everybody knows he's a day trader. You know, what an idiot I was. What an idiot. I don't know. Just an innocence. An innocence. You know, we're just stupid innocence. You know, giving a little tech support here about how you move a trade. That's it. In an innocence, and from our poverty state, we know nothing. We know nothing about the greed of others. We do not know. We've lived nothing of it in their greed cycle. Do you understand? But only ever lived in an impoverished state. So it's nothing. It's nothing all of a sudden to just be like, hey, here's the free information. You can have all this free information and I'll help you and blah blah blah. And then, well, yeah, you know, what's the hit for hire? Your own head. Your own head becomes the, yeah, the killer to yourself, you know. So I put this out there for him, you know, didn't I? So anyway, I have that drama. Anyway, I guess I'm winding out of dancing. I can't go there. It's I don't know. Seems to be a, I don't know, some people living in their small brains there. And so I don't know what to say. If they're living in small brains and small gossip intentions and trying to maintain their respectability in some manner, and I'm in their way, I'm like, well, you know, if I go on and on and on about everything, you know, I've gone on to all the ways of making the money, you know. And I'm like, well, if they want to make money from the situation, and yeah, I've met people that are so aggressive that yes, they will absolutely kill you. So when they want to make money from a situation, yeah, the easiest one would have been an insurance contract on a suicide. That is a very simple, because it's less messy. It's less messy for them. So when you push the woman into that situation, or you push the man into that situation, it's very, 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 it's less dangerous. They don't have gunpowder to their fingertips. You know, it's very, very simple. You know, the push of a person into their own suicide. So because of that, you know, they don't have to hold the contract. They don't have to hold the insurance contract. That insurance contract can be held by a family member. That insurance contract could be held by somebody else that has a gun to their head, essentially. Not necessarily so, but maybe they're just living off that one little bit of information. Oh, we just hate her because she didn't pay her rent. And that's not who we are. We're not those types of people. Yeah. So yeah, so we have the meanderance of a small brain the small brain accepting this little tiny bit of data and running with it like that final. When the miscreants of the deed extra and excelsior and engrandiose of the more and more greed are gaining, you understand? Their goal is to come in for the quickening after the whole effect. So I'm like, well, so if the person does not commit the suicide, that's a bummer for them, isn't it? If they die of natural causes, that's a bummer. So they have to move on. And hopefully in the interim, the husband hasn't been beaten too badly. And I'm like, well, then I'm wondering about my value and my worth in this situation, you know. Wondering about my value and my worth. There's no value and worth in making me homeless. They don't gain anything from that. I don't believe they gain anything from pushing me toward a prison or any type of health institute. They do not gain anything. So in a way, they almost have to drop the situation. Because the more I talk about this, in the event of my death, any contract that was held, any insurance contract, would be more and more and more suspect. So there would not be the payout. All right. So meanwhile, yeah, I don't know where my husband is, and if he does have the gun to his head, if they've beaten him so badly that he cannot even think any further, these are all possibles. And the, what was the third one? Oh, the meanderance of the typical state male that he's out just being the playboy doing whatever. Well, that is a dream. That is a dream. That I would be like, that would be normal. That would be normal. And we want normal in a way. We would prefer normal in a way. So under the guise of normal, there are also things that can be hidden. So I never even trust the guise of normal, you understand? Not when you're a day trader. Not when you're successful as he. Interestingly, no. No. He was not one actually traded his own money. Interesting. Anyhoo, that's all. Yeah, I don't think they're going to bait me off to Russia. I had been working out pretty heavily for it, though. I suppose they still could swipe me out there. Maybe that's what's holding me back on my sit-ups. I don't really like the water bath.